within 32 days. What is the IR camera is doing in this experiment is that IR images of the two round of magnetic hypothermia treatment is showing that targeted heat, that is between 42 to 43 degrees Celsius only at the tumor site, whereas at the peripheral tumor temperature was much, much less. As we go beyond from this point, rest of the body was in the normal range. This is what is the aim of the experiment. And this is what is the aim of the, the scientist to do any kind of cancer research. These IR images are also showing the difference in size of the tumor during the first and the second session. Now, in the next, what you can say here is the next part of the talk. We will talk about the size of the cancer of the first one, and the beginning of this in the first one, and then it is removed at the last part. After finishing this, I will go to another topic that is also the GMR, but how this GMR, that the giant magnetoresistance effect,
for us, can thanks for once again being with us.
Field of biology, GMR in biosensors daily. This is what the tumor we have started doing this by using the instrumentation which is available. With me in the point, our aim is to. We have developed some in the lab atmosphere, but not in the production line. It will take few more, years, maybe not, if not years, maybe a 6 months time more, to get a kit of a point of care detection kit for the early stage cancer detection. So what we need is, the key challenges for this are, India is passing through to develop advanced approaches for timely detection of cancer. A significant proportion of the cancer can be cured by surgery or radiotherapy or chemotherapy only if detected very early stage. In the existing method, currently available cancer tests are only work when a full-fledged tumor has been developed. So, a early stage detection is the basic aim of any researcher. First stage, as I said, there are four stages. First, second, third, and fourth. It is very difficult to take in the first stage, at least the second stage, if the detection unit can develop, that is going to be helpful for human being. So detect the tumor at the early stage. Instrument complexity is high, requirement constraints are there for the personnel and expensive. These are the methods which are available nowadays. Legging of the point of care analysis, this is the first point which we have taken up to do a point of care detection kit, not in the hospital or the lab atmosphere. So the limited outreach to rural areas where the prevalence is very high, the limited sensitivity of the detection unit which is available here. But if you use the GMR kind of sensor, one can go even to the lower limit. So what one can do is, by use of the point of care GMR sensor. So this is the tri-layer structure. On the top of the layer, what you have is antigen antibody kind of augmentation on the surface of the tumor. The GMR structure with targeted antigen, which are for a specific, then the antibody are coated to the magnetic nanoparticles, then doing the detection of this from the fringe field. So on the surface of the GMR sensor, the captured antibodies are functionalized specific for target antigen, that is the cancer biomarker. The target antigens are code which are specifically bind with its captured target antibody on the surface of the GMR, what you can see here, which specifically bind with target antigen. At this antibody sandwich form, there is change in resistivity. And this change in resistivity, a small change in resistivity, can be detected by the GMR biosensor. So what we are going to tell more about is the optimization studies to determine the biomarkers associated with each clinical stage of oral cancer. So this is about showing this, the oral cancers. So use a biomarker in the DNA. What you can see here is, so what we have done is the 10 ml blood in the tumor tissues isolated from the cancer positive person. One half of the sample are taken from molecular biology, and the respective second half of the sample are subjected to the histopathological analysis just to verify what we are doing is correct or not for determining the grade of the cancer. So the total leukocyte count was also obtained on blood samples. So what we are doing here is the use of disease biomarker in the form of DNA or the RNA or the protein is emerging as one of the most promising strategies for our understanding of disease biology or the management diagnosis. A biomarker is, what is a biomarker? A biomarker is a molecular signature that makes the initiation of a disease and ultimately offers the powerful methods to diagnose and treat the disease at a desired time. Despite an array of identical biomarkers, early detection of cancer is yet to reach in a clinical practice level. So the proposed solution in our effect is that this proposed technology is through a very sensitive GMR sensor. The proposed technology aims to develop an advanced and highly efficient electronic nanobiosensor for detecting cancer to ultra sensitive, multiplex, and the real time electronic readout.
So there is a voice problem.
And rapid biological chemical detection. Can you hear now? Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now it's audible, sir.
Okay, I have to just come near to the computer, I guess, a little bit more. Okay. So in the next slide, what we have done is the isolation of DNA and the RNA. In the third slide, in the PCR testing, what we have done is once cancer grade are determined from biopsy, the RNA isolated from tissues and blood samples are run against a known panel of biomarker common to oral cancer. This is for the oral cancer treatment. The expression levels and the incidence of each of the markers are tailored against the grade of the cancer. This step helps us determine the biomarkers corresponding to each clinical stage of the cancers. So the working principle for this and the next slide, I'll just show here how we develop this, fabricate this spintronic based biosensor using a multi-layer GMR spin verb structure, top-down approach. This is a GMR biosensor. What you can see here is, are a number of sensors which are something like 100 by 100 microns of the sizes. Inside these sizes, there are 64 by 64 elements, and the readouts are there which are parallel connected to amplify the signal of the sensor. Then the working principle of technique is that the small change in the resistance in GMR nanobiosensor upon binding of cancer-specific oligonucleotide from the patient blood is the basic principle of ultra-sensitive sensor, which is first response time. So in order to support the multiple target genes, separate GMR sensor, as I showed here, the separate GMR sensors are developed here. They are fabricated in a single biosensor chip. So this is a 100 micron by 100 micron one of the sensor. They are designed on top of a silicon substrate, which I show here. The silicon substrate we took. Then on top of this is a tantalum layer of 5 nanometer. Then we have a hard layer, iridium manganese. This is the bottom antiferromagnetic layer. As I said, the lower magnetic layer is fixed layer in a GMR sensor. To make it a fix, one is to put a kind of a magnet. So this is not a magnet, but it's an antiferromagnetic layer, iridium manganese. On top of this, we have a ruthenium layer, then we have a iron cobalt layer, then the top layers and the capping layer. So to design, after designing this, we did the electron beam evaporation technique to design this, then did the photolithography to design this 100 micron by 100 micron, and also the signal lines from the copper to make the, through the photolithography, we designed the sensors. Now the pre-designated primers specific for the kind of cancer genes are employed through the biotin-related chemicals. The biotin-related capture nuclei acids will be robotically spotted on the surface of the sensor. Then the DNA, RNA will be isolated from the, as I said in the earlier slide, 10 ml of blood collected from the suspected individual. Then the virus capture oligonucleotide or the complementary DNA. They're exposed to the target sample of the patient. Then it is hybridization takes place only if the patient is cancer positive. Magnetic nanoparticles conjugated with streptavidin will they attach to the biotin-related probes on the sensor surface and generate a signal on the GMR structure. So this binding of magnetic nanoparticles onto the GMR sensor, they cause the change in resistance. As you saw, that there is a change in resistance, and this resistance change, whether it is a very negligible resistance change, can also be detected by the GMR sensor, which are measured in a real-time electrical readout. And what you can see here in the next slide is this. This is what I am saying now. And then there's a functionalize. The first slide is the functionalization of the sensor surface. Then the hybridization with the complementary biotin-related sequences found in the blood, the biotin, then conjugate with the nanoparticles on the sensor surface to the GMR on top layer of the GMR. So this technology lays the concept and the practice founded for a multi-gene blood test nanobiosensor. So by attaching the multiple probes, as I showed there, there's a multiple probes for the multiple sensor surface. One can target more than one cancer type to detect what kind of cancer is there. So this is the biology part, and then also the final product, something like this, with the GMR sensor. This GMR sensor is photolithographically done to make 100 micron by, this is on a 10 millimeter by 10 millimeter chip. Then it is down to 100 micron by 100 micron, one of the chip of the GMR. Inside this GMR chip, then electron beam lithographically, we have made 64 sensors, 8 by 8 sensor in one of the black, what you can see here. Then the readouts are serially, they are connected to make amplify the signal to get an output, so that one of the sensor surface, when it is positive, what you can see here through a microcontroller, one can see a readout here. This is just a handheld kind of device. This is our planning, but the final product is yet to come. So the final product has the GMR sensor chip with voltage biasing provided by a pre-programmed microcontroller powered by AA cells, the readouts to different voltages reading for each detection of stage of the cancer. For each stage, the voltage output would be assigned to a different value that will be standardized against the known cancer positive patients. So this is all about the GMR kind of technology, what we are doing in my lab in JNU now. These are my earlier students, collaborators, and those are just changed to IIIT Delhi. This is Dr. Ramakrishna. Swati Midha is a biologist. Now she has joined the University College, UK, London. Vinay is there in Morgan State University. Monica and other people are there in Delhi University teaching. Anindita is a chemist. Anjali is again a biologist, just finished her PhD. There are few more PhD students, and these two are already submitted, and they are doing the research in my lab still, and are going to submit it very soon. Over the world, I have the collaboration. I started my GMR sensor work with Peter at UCCS, collaborated with Stephen Matt. Now he is in Western Digital. Pablo Cabos, he is in the NIST Boulder. Of course, Veera was a lab mate for me at UCCS. This Malkinsky, Leszek Malkinsky, also a lab mate when I joined UCCS in 2002 at the beginning of this. Then he joined Emory University of New Orleans. Now he's a professor there. T. Kalkur is a EE expert in the EE department at UCCS Colorado Springs. He is also a sensor guy, but he does not make much of the ferromagnetic sensor, but he make the hybrid and also the ferroelectric sensors. Sanjay is a good friend of mine. He is a professor at University of Memphis. He usually start giving me the magnetic nanowires when I was at Colorado Springs to make the planar devices on top of the nanowires to make the unbiased MMICs. So I would like to thank all of you listening to me, and also I put my emails. If you want to call me, I have a website in the JNU site, and these are the emails. You can send me your queries also, and also I'll take a few of your queries. Now, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for your very exhaustive presentation. Participants, now it's the time for interaction with the resource person. In case if you have any specific questions, you can put down your questions in the chat window so that the resource person can help us to sort out the clarifications, please.
Can I see the chat window also? Should I stop sharing this, then only I can see? Or what should I do?
Participants, you can use the chat window to type your questions, or you can unmute and you can speak also.
Yeah, please. I cannot hear. Is there a question?
Yes, sir. How GMR sensor better than label-free biosensor?
How GMR sensor better than?
Label-free biosensor.
Label-free biosensor. Well, the other sensors people have designed, even transistor-based FET, 25 transistor-based sensor, I think this is the name which you took also. This is another kind of a sensor. So what I can say is that from my experience, GMR is a structure which can detect even a micro-ohms change in resistance. Micro-ohms change. I'm going to 10 to the minus 6 range. So this is the beauty of the GMR technology over the other sensor. So if you compare a read-write head, how small the cells are there, you will be hearing from other people from Seagate. So what I claim is that whatever the sensors are there, they are of course good. And I hope the GMR sensor is going to be even better.
So the next question is,
can I see there?
Are millimeter 5G waves harmful to humans?
See, microwave is always harmful. Even then, we are using microwave at home. Okay? We are heating our food. And 5G, as you said, it is such a high frequency, that means the wavelength is so small. there is going to be harmful. That is, you are very much right. But if you want to go for new technology, more data speed, less latency, and high speed, then you have to tolerate this kind of little bit of harms, I guess. The harm which is going to be produced, because 5G is already there. I mean, in US, I think Taiwan and Russia, they've already introduced, and maybe more people can tell. So it is going to be a little bit harmful, but the more effective will be the data transfer rate, that is the fast, how fast it is, the latency and the fastness of this technology. This is going to be really, really wonderful.
So the next question is, how nanotechnology can be used for curing COVID-19?
Well, as I showed one of the slides, one can think of sensors. As I said, the same sensor which we are working now for the cancer detection, we just applied to the biotechnology, DBT, Department of Biotechnology, the same kind of sensor with other kind of functionation and all, the GMR sensor for the detection of the COVID-19. Because as you saw, many RT-PCR detection kits are there where you can see the COVID positive, negative. Of course, there are false negative, false positive are coming up. There are many. So one has to compromise with this. I mean, fastness and accurateness. And I guess the GMR technology can be useful much accurately than the antigen and antibody based sensors for the RT-PCR.
Sir, and next question is, how nanotechnology can be used in ceramic technology?
Nanotechnology in ceramic technology, I have not thought of this, but one can Google in the Google Scholar to see the what we can do in the ceramic technology. I mean, many people from the metallurgical department, what I can see in IIT Delhi or my collaborator in IIT Delhi, they, many of the metallurgical department, they are using in the metallurgical or the ceramic technology there. Ceramic can be a hard material can be designed, very hard material can be designed, which can be just as a presence of my mind, what I can say is that very hard and very thin layer can be designed for the aeroplanes or the tankers, which the bullet cannot enter. Through the nanotechnology, use of nanotechnology, as I said, nanotechnology can also be used as a camouflage. This area of research also we have started. The camouflage means you can make your aeroplane or the radar vanish from the radar. Particles with the hardest material, you can make the surface of your it can think of. But more research one in Google Scholar.
Sir, and our next question is, what will be the cost of point of care device using GMR sensor?
Well, we have given a number to biotechnology department. This is not going to be very, very high. It will be in few thousands what we have proposed them. Only thing is the capital cost. As I said, a GMR sensor is only applicable if we have a structure which is a single crystalline. A single crystalline, in a polycrystalline, the GMR value is going to be reduced drastically. So the GMR, you cannot see a very large value. For this, one has to design a single crystalline GMR sensor. So for this, the capital cost is little high. That means one need a some kind of a good deposition system or a good ultra high vacuum system. Ultra high means it has to be more than 10 to the power minus 9, minus 10 range of torque. In that, one can design a single crystalline or a monocrystalline epitaxial thin films, multi-layers, tri-layers, and spintronic layers. And then the GMR will be much, much higher than the sputtering system. Sputtering system is very much friendly to the commercial people because they want to grow a large scale of devices in a small time. Though the GMR value is drastically reduced in that, but still one can think of doing that. So we have proposed the both in the single crystalline based as well as the polycrystalline based in the industry used sputtering technique to design these sensors. There are census papers that are available in the internet, in the Google Scholar. There are many papers which are published in Nature and Science also, but very few. So this is going to be, one has to be careful about if it is a price, then one has to go for a sputtering technique to make the GMR or the tri-layer or the spin valve structure. If it is a price is okay, I'm not saying price is okay means lakhs in rupees of Indian rupees, but it is much, much less. What I'm saying is tens of thousand, meaning tens of thousand, maybe 10,000, 15,000, a device, point of care device. This is what is our plan.
Sir, and the next question is commercializing the biosensor using nanoparticles feasible? If yes. So, how long will it take to fabricate one?
See, this is all in the lab stage at this moment. At least in India, I can say. In the US also, I guess. But the other medical people, like, for example, Dr. Veera, he's going to talk, I think, more about this, I hope. And then some other people, biology, those who are doing. So in Indian atmosphere, this biosensor is on the R&D stage only, not in the commercial stage. But what I can presume, this can go to commercial stage if some people will come up, some SMEs, some young entrepreneur, young industrialists will come up and collaborate with the academia persons to make it feasible within a year time. That's what I can see the future.
And sir, there are questions on how nanotechnology can be used in the fields of number one, computer science, number two, biotechnology, and number three, bamboo technology.
Third is what?
Bamboo technology.
Bamboo technology. I have no idea about the bamboo technology. Okay. The first, what he said, is the computer science, it is okay. You saw everything is there. Nanotechnology is first device. What I can remember is when Peter Grünberg was alive, he unfortunately died a few years before. He said to me once that this is the first application of nanotechnology that they have discovered in late 80s. But before that also, nanotechnology is already there in our ancient time also. There are so many nanoparticles coated vessels one can see. When I was in Cologne in Germany, I saw in the church there, that is called as there are many paintings are there which are decorated with nanoparticles which are having different colors when the sun movement changes. When it is in the morning time, in the noon time, or in the evening time, it changes. So it is all there. I mean, every time it is all the way back to centuries. And now it is comes up, as Veera said, in the Feynman as was discovered.
Sir, and next question is, how is the scope of nanotechnology in India compared to abroad? Can engineer work in medical field using nanotechnology?
I think people have started using this. People started using this. It's not that bad in India. As I said in my introductory, just a 3 minutes talk, that India is third placed in publishing research paper. But if you see the number of patents, the number of translational research for the application or the devices are hardly any. India is at the 18th or 20th place in the patent technology. Application in the bioscience, I think people have started using it. In the technology, I think some people have started using it as a coating on the PPE kits. On the PPE kits, if you coat them and just put it on the sun and just put it inside a microwave oven, it will be clean. In place of putting it in a washing machine, just a plain microwaves, and then it will remove all the virus and kill all the virus from this.
Sir, and the next question is, what are the uncovered fields that can be used in nanotechnology? The other question is, scope of nanotechnology in weapon making.
Weapon making, I never thought that way, but defense people are using. I was a member of some of the defense institute. Those who are under the JNU, they give some BTech, MTech and PhD degree. I usually attend their academic council, and then they are using the C-band. C-band means up to 6 gigahertz, 4 or 6 gigahertz, but they are planning to use, even going towards the higher side. Higher side means small device. Small device means one has to use the nanotechnology for this. So defense is going to use for every time. Weaponry, I directly have no exposure to this, but as I said, it can be through the nanoparticles as a camouflage for the radars or the planes from the enemy radars. It can be many devices, which can be a signal processing devices like MMICs, which I talked about. There are many other applications also there in the nanotechnology fields for electronics, what I can guess.
Sir, COVID-19 virus always changes its RNA. So how can nanotechnology cope with those changes?
I think this question, even the director of AIIMS Delhi, Dr. Guleria, cannot answer. So I'm sorry, I cannot answer this question.
Okay, sir. Next question is, fabrication of biosensors using biopolymer, is it possible, sir? Fabrication of biosensors using biopolymers, whether it is possible?
I think it is possible. Only one is to sit down with the chemist and some chemist, biologist and some physics people. So if three people can come together, everything is possible in the nanotechnology world, what I can say. Only discrete things are not possible in the nanoscience. So one has to be a physicist, a material science, one has to be a biologist, one has to be a chemist. All the three or the four people, if sit together, just giving besides their egos, then everything is possible in the nano world.
Sir, and what is the role of nanotechnology in material science?
And many. Whatever I talk is all material science. All material science, new materials, development of new materials, whether it is a magnetic material, whether it is a ferroelectric, ferromagnetic, nanoparticles, coarse cell nanoparticles, holo nanoparticles, hundreds and thousands of material science applications are there. Many.
And what is the property of Fe3O4 that made destruction of uncontrolled cell generation, that is tumor cells? What is the property of Fe3O4 that made destruction of uncontrolled cell generation,
To my knowledge, Fe304, what we have used is for generating the heat, because they are magnetic, ferromagnetic. When you have an alternating magnetic field coming or absorbing these nanoparticles, the Fe304 nanoparticles are absorbing these electromagnetic energy. They are radiating the transfer, I mean, change, translating the electromagnetic energy to the heat energy because of the energy conservation of energy rule. So that heat is ablating or killing the cancer cells. That is the property which we are using for the ablation of the cancer cells through hypothermia, or people are using it as a contraceptive also.
So I think with this, we will close this session. I think sir has been with us for almost half a day. So thank you, sir.